The Kalungu West Member of Parliament, Joseph Gonzaga Sewungu, opened Pandora's box during plenary when he raised a procedural matter, expressing concerns about MPs disregarding rules of procedure, which categorically underlines the appropriate dress codes for sitting legislators and choosing to dress casually.
Speaker, I'm raising a procedural matter. This House has rules of procedure, and among them, there's dress code. This House is changing slowly but on a slow but sure dose on dress code. And when I come as a member of parliament and above all shadow minister of education, I dress smart, as you can see me here, Mr. Speaker.
And what we will do next week, we shall meet the leader of opposition, the government chief whip, the whips, the chairman, committee on rules, the speaker, and I. We contemplate on this matter and we give proper guidance that is harmonized to members in as far as interpretation of the rules on dressing is concerned.
Rule 82A of the Rules of Procedure mandates male MPs to wear suits with neckties, safari suits, a kanzu and a jacket, decent traditional wear and military attire for members of the armed forces. Females, on the other hand, must put on a dress, blouse and skirt, decent traditional wear and military attire for the members of the armed forces. The parliament spokesperson, Chris Obore, has come out to condemn the vice and tasked legislators to wipe themselves.
Parliament are the ones supposed to uphold that tradition. If the concerns are coming up now, it therefore implies that the members need to whip themselves because they are the leaders of this house. And one of their roles is role modeling. If they begin to disobey their own dress code, how will they supervise the staff?
Sewungu, the mover of the matter, and other lawmakers explained how MPs have lost the decorum and embraced indecence over the years.
Indecent dressing is an issue and it can cost someone a constituency for dressing indecently. But day by day, I am seeing that we are going on a slow but sure dose of members dressing indecently. Someone is coming from his farm, dressed the way he wants, he enters parliament. But we have rules governing us how to dress. Traditional wear, Kaunda suit.
Sarah Kayagi Netari Sire, the Namisindwa District Woman Member of Parliament, says the dressing is not only a problem of male MPs, but women too, as some wear skirts that are above their knees and make onlookers uncomfortable.
Seated in that house, our benches that we sit on don't give us space to cover our thighs, which are open. So I think even as the female members of parliament, it is of due respect.
Legislators share mixed opinions as some oppose reforms in the dress code of parliament to do away with the colonial settings and sentiments. They argue that the fashion industry changes at a rapid speed and parliament should fall in line.
No, I believe we should have an adjustment, an amendment to that specific rule of procedure, especially on the dress code. Because modernity has come on, we have Kaunda suits on, we have the Nigerian wares.
A tradition. What is the Mandela shirt? What is their culture in South Africa, that dress code in their country? Those ones, we have to look at them. So if you want to come Mandela shirt, put it in our rules that I can wear any shirt. I can go in my t-shirt in the parliament. But not accepting in this sense against the rules we put in place by ourselves.
Parliament made a lot of adjustments with time to accept the African wear, Kaunda suits, Mandela shirts, among others. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.